So thank you very much for giving such a nice opportunity to have you on Tulu News. The situation in Afghanistan has been deteriorated badly after ISAF's mission. Many think that ANSF ability was mistakenly overestimated. What do you think of that?
I think that Afghanistan is making real progress, and I think that it's important that NATO continues to support Afghanistan. And what we have seen is that the Afghan National Army security forces have been able to take full charge, full responsibility of the security in the country. We never believed that that was going to be easy. But we have also seen that the Afghan forces have been able to handle the situation and also to deny the terrorists any safe haven in Afghanistan. So we will continue to support Afghanistan and we will continue to work very closely with both the government and the armed forces of Afghanistan.
And looking to the what happened in Kunduz in after widespread violence all around the country from east to west, south to north, it seems that there are some shortage.
I think what happened in Kunduz and also what you have seen in other places in Afghanistan just underlines that it is a demanding task to fight the terrorists, to fight insurgents. And that's the reason why NATO has supported Afghanistan in building a capable, professional, dedicated army and security forces with over 350,000 soldiers and police. And 2015 was a difficult year, 2016 is going to be a difficult year, and this is going to be something which will require our full attention for a long time. But that's the reason why NATO will continue to support the Afghans, help them with developing new capabilities. For instance, now we are working with Afghanistan on how to strengthen and develop air forces of the Afghan armed forces. So we need to support Afghanistan, strengthening their armed forces and developing new capabilities to be able to cope with and to respond to the aggressive actions of the insurgents.
Could you please explain a little bit more regarding the equipping of air forces of Afghanistan? What shall not we do that?
Sorry,
Air forces of Afghanistan.
What we are doing with the air force is that NATO and NATO allies are helping Afghanistan with both developing the air force, getting new planes, equipment, but also, of course, training and the infrastructure which is needed when a new and more modern air force is developed. So NATO and NATO allies are helping the Afghans with developing a much stronger air force. And just as an example, last year the Afghan air forces made 20,000 missions, which is twice as many as the year before. So this is just one example of how the capabilities of the Afghan air forces are increasing. Of course, we have to continue to fill gaps, to modernize, to get the new equipment. But all of this is just one of many examples of how we are enabling, strengthening the capabilities of the Afghan forces.
What's your estimation? How long it will take? How many years after we may have proper air forces?
We have already achieved important things when it comes to strengthening the Afghan air forces. They are now conducting more missions. They are able to conduct more operations than they that the Afghan Air Force was able to do just a few years ago. But at the same time, there are gaps, there are new challenges, and that's the reason why we will continue to strengthen the Afghan Air Force.
And just yesterday, there was a debate in UN Security Council, and Afghan ambassador in the UN and General Secretary Special Representative to Afghanistan shared their deep concerns on border shelling from Pakistan and regarding the security situation in the country. What's your word on that?
The fundamental assessment is that the Afghan government, the Afghan armed forces, are faced with great challenges, and that also this year, 2016, is going to be a difficult year. But at the same time, what we have seen is that the Afghan forces, supported by NATO and the United States, is able to cope with the challenges. And I have strong confidence in the Afghan army and the unity government. And that's the reason why we will continue to support them and enable them to cope with the challenges they are faced with.
In a part of reserve support, there some debates have been raised in U.S. Defense Ministry and Senate as well, looking for to increase the engagement of U.S. troops in Afghanistan to fight against insurgency. Would be there any changes in the NATO current engagement?
So we are constantly assessing the resident support mission and how we can make that mission as effective and as targeted as possible. And that's the reason why we are also now opening up for a more flexible approach, being able to assist and train not only in Kabul but also more around in the whole country. That's also the reason why we are looking into how we can provide, for instance, more intelligence, reconnaissance and surveillance support for the Afghan army. And we are also looking into other ways of being more flexible. So we will adapt and we will adjust, but based on the current mandate that this is a non-combat operation where we support the Afghans, NATO is not being part of a combat operation. What we are doing is that the United States is of course also helping with fighting the insurgents and the counter-terrorist operations.
As the last question, two big events, Brussels Summit and Warsaw Summit and Brussels Ministerial Conference ahead. Would be there any new pledges regarding Afghanistan? Would be there any new pledges regarding Afghanistan in these two events?
Afghanistan and the rest of the support mission is going to be one of the main topics we are going to address at the Warsaw Summit in July, where heads of states and government of the NATO countries are going to meet. And I expect them to make new decisions, new commitments regarding both the support to Afghanistan, the rescue support mission, the future of the mission, but also when it comes to continued financial support, funding the Afghan army and security forces. And all this we do because we want to support a new, modern, democratic, stable Afghan society. And part of that is also the press, the media. A free independent press. So have a strong free independent press is part of the new and modern Afghanistan we all strive for. And this, I discussed these challenges and also the preparations for the Warsaw Summit with both President Ghani and Chief Executive Abdullah during my visit here in Kabul. And I feel very confident that they are strongly committed to continue to pursue the path of reforms, to modernize Afghanistan and to fight corruption, and of course to work with NATO allies and partners to fight the insurgents and to create a lasting peace in Afghanistan.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you. Thank you.